mixes easier. You record it and it just sits, and you don't have to struggle with it.
That's a good point, Carson. It just seems to make it easier to just make it sound right.
It's two things. It sits in a mix better, but it cuts through the mix better. It does both of those at the same time.
Yeah.
And most digitals, sometimes they could do one or the other, but it's rare when you could do both of those at the same time.
That one turned me down a little bit, yeah. Alright, so, hi, I'm Carson. I was lucky enough to...
Yeah, Carson.
Say thank you guys. It was very privileged to be able to work on this thing. And totally blown away. So I guess I'll just kind of, similar to the stuff on the videos, I haven't done anything new. Assume a lot of you guys have seen the videos that are out. So I'm just going to run through a song with some beat effects and kind of toy around. Feel free to holler out questions or, you know, stop me. I'm happy to talk about stuff. I do want to say one thing I really loved about this is not having like built-in effects in a way, thinking about synthesizing sounds, you know, how do you make something sound like it has reverb if you have to synthesize it from, you know, envelopes and filters, and you can do stuff that sounds like delay by doing kind of modulating different envelopes against each other. And it's just really, really deep. You can spend, you know, I would spend almost 10 hours a day just like tweaking a sound. you can get that way. So I'll just kind of play through some stuff.
Thank you.
Mention that distortion sound he had did not use the distortion. That was using feedback.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch about the, because the feedback pattern's only off the left channel of the pan, correct? So you can really tweak what you're sending to it, and then really tune it with the high pass filter too. That was one of my favorite features, is actually just the pre-post filter thing. Mm-hmm. Oh, this thing is solid. I mean, they're built here, right?
San Francisco built.
Yeah.